Alex flies with his class to Paris for 10 days. At the airport, he learns that the departure time coincides with his birthday. Then, obeying a bad feeling, Alex leaves the plane in a panic, and sometime later the plane explodes. But soon the passengers, who got off with Alex, begin to die one by one. Hello everyone, this is Director of Hollywood. Today I'm going to tell you about the movie Final Destination. The film's protagonist, high school student Alex Browning, goes on a school trip to Paris. Apparently, Alex is terrified of flying, but tries to hide it. Soon after takeoff, the plane explodes, and Alex's classmates die in flames before his eyes. The moment death catches up with Alex himself, he suddenly wakes up in the seat of the Boeing 747 preparing to take off on flight 180. Frightened, he begins to notice that moments from his vision, such as his classmates' remarks or the broken recliner, begin to repeat themselves in reality. Alex begins to panic and tries to get off the plane. Because of the situation, Alex, teacher Valerie Luton, tough guy Carter Horton, Carter's girlfriend Terry Chaney, and student Billy Hitchcock are dropped from the plane, while orphan Claire Rivers and Alex's best friend Todd Wagner get off by themselves so they can settle down and get on the next flight. The plane with the remaining passengers takes off and immediately explodes. Two FBI agents take statements from the people removed from the plane, and especially from Alex. 39 days later, a memorial is unveiled at a memorial evening at the school to honor those who died on that flight. Carter refuses to talk to Alex. Terry tries to apologize to him for his boyfriend. Miss Luton is afraid of Alex, and Todd invites Alex to a hockey game. That night at his house in the bathroom, Todd slips on a puddle, a clothesline entangling itself around his neck. Because of the slippery bathtub, Todd is unable to free himself and dies. Everyone but Alex considers his death a suicide. Alex was at the scene of the tragedy and sees Claire there. The next day he goes to her house and tries to find out why she was there. Claire states that she feels about the same way Alex does, but that she is not experiencing visions. Alex and Claire guess that death is coming for them. They decide to take a look at the dead Todd. When Alex and Claire go to the morgue to see his body, the mysterious undertaker William Bladworth tells them that death is intervening to kill everyone who should have died on the plane. The next day, Alex tries to convince Claire of Todd's murder, but she doesn't believe him. Carter and Terry drive up to them, nearly hitting Billy Hitchcock, who is riding his bicycle. At this time, Valerie Luton comes out of a nearby store, who also approaches them and informs them of her intention to leave town in a week. The boys quarrel again. Terry gets fed up with their yelling and leaves Carter and yells at him as she crosses the street. Immediately, she is hit by a bus at high speed. At home, watching a report on the crash of Flight 180, Alex concludes that death kills the survivors in the same order in which they would have died if the plane had exploded. Based on this, he realizes that the next target on death's list is Miss Luton. He rushes to her house, but there is a fire in Miss Luton's house. A rack of knives falls on the teacher, one stabbing her in the chest. Valerie lies helplessly on the floor. Alex prepares to pull out the knife, but the stool falls on that knife and stabs it deep inside, killing Miss Luton. Alex runs out of the house seconds before the explosion, and then he runs home. Billy Hitchcock witnesses the explosion. Claire Rivers is questioned by FBI agents and they suspect Alex of the murders because he touched the knife that killed Ms. Luton and his shoe sole marks are imprinted on the floor in her blood. Alex contacts Billy, Claire, and Carter to tell them about his theory. They decide to drive out of town in Carter's car. Alex has a vision of a train and a broken seatbelt. Carter, knowing from Alex that he is next, races at breakneck speed down the highway and stops his car on a railroad track. Carter wants to kill himself before death does. At the last moment, however, he changes his mind, but is unable to get out of his car because his seatbelt is jammed. Carter tries to start the car, but the engine won't start, and the car doors lock by themselves. The train gets closer and closer, and soon it rams the car with Carter. Alex rushes to help Carter out of his car and breaks his seatbelt, just as Alex anticipated, and Carter is freed seconds before the train crashes into the car, thereby cheating death. Carter moves to the end of death's list. Seconds later, a shard of Carter's car slices off the head of Billy Hitchcock, who screams at this moment that he will live. At home, Alex realizes with horror that Billy died because he saved Carter. Death missed Carter and struck the next victim, Billy. He further realizes that Death's next victim is not him, but Claire. Alex rushes to her house and finds her in a car surrounded by fire. She is unable to escape from her vehicle, which threatens to explode as a damaged electrical cable snaps around. Alex saves her by lifting the cable, but receives a severe electric shock himself. Claire and the FBI agents run to Alex. 6 months later, Alex, Claire, and Carter are in Paris, talking about Flight 180. Alex believes they are still on the list, just that death has given them a reprieve. Alex goes out for a walk, as he senses danger. Thinking, Alex doesn't notice the bus rushing at him, only Claire's scream saves him. The bus crashes into a pole, which hits a sign that falls on Alex. At the last moment, Carter pushes him away. He asks Alex who is next on death's list. A sign reading Moreau 81, which flips to Get 180 Rome, refers to the disaster. It, having made a twist on its axis, falls on Carter. The screen goes dark. You can hear a loud hard thump that leaves Alex and Claire as the last survivors of Flight 180. That's all for today. Subscribe and like it if you want more videos like this.